Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chansom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 28th of August. Top elite commanders among six terrorists neutralized in India's Jammu and Kashmir. Activists say no hope for justice after killing of Baloch youth by Pakistani forces. And Sri Lankan government approves to abolish 19th amendment to the constitution. And now for all the details. A senior police official said on Thursday that two top commanders of Pakistan-based Lashkar-e-Taiba terror outfit were among the six terrorists neutralized this week in India's Jammu and Kashmir. Among them, four were included in the top 10 wanted list of the terrorists, the official said.
Two top commanders of Pakistan-based Lashkar-e-Taiba or LET terror outfit were among the six terrorists neutralized by security forces over the past 4 days in India's Jammu and Kashmir, a senior police official said on Thursday. In a big win for the security forces, Lashkar-e-Taiba commander Nasiruddin Lone, involved in killing of paramilitary personnel, and one other terrorist were gunned down in an encounter that broke out in Handwara town of Jammu and Kashmir late on Wednesday night. A huge cache of arms and ammunition, including two AK-47s, were also recovered from their possession. This came after another LET commander, Sajjad Haider, and two other terrorists were gunned down in an encounter on Monday, soon after they killed three security personnel at a checkpost in Kariri area of Baramulla district.
I understand that in the past 4 days, there were 3 operations in the past. कल एक साथ ही साथ ऑपरेशन शोपियां में भी चल रहा था जिसमें एक आतंकी हिजबुल मुजाहिदीन का मारा गया तालिब हुसैन 3 आतंकी करीरी में जो 3 दिन पहले इनकाउंटर हुआ उसमें मारे गए और ये 2 आतंकी जहां पर मारे गए
इंडिया हैज लॉन्ग एक्यूज्ड पाकिस्तान ऑफ ट्रेनिंग एंड इन्फिल्ट्रेटिंग टेररिस्ट्स फ्रॉम अक्रॉस द बॉर्डर टू स्प्रेड अनरेस्ट इन कश्मीर वैली. Pakistan, however, denies the allegations.
India scaled a new peak in daily testing as more than 900,000 COVID-19 tests were conducted in the last 24 hours and the positivity rate has come down to below 8%, informed India's health ministry on Thursday. Meanwhile, over 29% in the national capital have developed antibodies against COVID-19, the second seroprevalence survey conducted in Delhi in the first week of August has shown. India's health ministry on Thursday informed that the country has scaled a new peak in daily testing as 918,470 COVID-19 tests were conducted in the last 24 hours. According to the ministry, the positivity rate has come down to below 8%. Notably, India has registered over 60,000 recoveries in the preceding 24 hours, which was the highest number of recoveries from the deadly virus in a single day. Meanwhile, according to the second serological survey conducted earlier this month, a total of 29.1% people in the national capital have developed antibodies against COVID-19. Seroprevalence survey involves testing blood serum of individuals to check for prevalence of antibodies against the viral infection. In the second round of the sero survey, over 15,000 samples were collected, spanning different areas and age groups. Representative samples were taken from all 11 districts of the national capital.
इस बार इस serological survey में 29.1%, 29.1% लोग दिल्ली के अंदर एंटीबॉडीज उनमें मिली है 29.1 उनके अंदर एंटीबॉडीज मिली हैं. एंटीबॉडीज का मतलब ये है कि वो इन्फेक्ट होकर ठीक हो चुके हैं. तो दिल्ली की आबादी अगर 2 करोड़ माना जाए तो इसके हिसाब से लगभग 58 लाख लोगों को वो एंटीबॉडीज बन चुकी हैं और वो ठीक हो चुके हैं.
विद द लेटेस्ट स्पाइक इंडियाज़ टोटल कोरोना वायरस केसेस स्टैंड एट 2.8,036,926 व्हिच इज इंक्लूसिव ऑफ 686,395 एक्टिव केसेस. India's Western Maharashtra state is the worst affected state from the infection. Moving on, Baloch activists have said they have no hope for justice in the recent case of killing of a youth in Balochistan by Pakistan's paramilitary frontier corps. The incident has once again highlighted the issue of extrajudicial killings in the region.
Baloch activists have raised concerns over the recent killing of Hayat Mirza, a Karachi University student, by Pakistan's frontier corps in Turbat City, which has once again highlighted ongoing human rights violations in Balochistan. Hayat Mirza was picked up from an orchard and shot dead in front of his father in cold blood by the paramilitary forces last week as they had cordoned off an area post an attack on them by pro-freedom Baloch armed groups. Protests have erupted across Balochistan to demand justice for Hayat Mirza and over the rising cases of enforced disappearances and extrajudicial killings by Pakistani security forces in the region. In the latest, a soldier accused for the killing was identified on Wednesday by Hayat Mirza's father and a probe is underway. But activists say they have no hopes for justice.
We all know the truth that nothing will happen at the end because this is not the first time where Pakistani forces have killed people in front of many eyewitnesses and the case went down and no one was ever punished.
It is always Pakistani army and ISPR which defines the Pakistani national narrative and Pakistani press just follow that. Balochistan is a no-go area for the journalist. And like its people missing from the national narratives.
Baloch activists accuse that Pakistan army has been carrying so-called military operations in the region for years with an aim to eliminate the Baloch people. They blame thousands have been internally displaced because of armed conflicts and army operations over the years.
In news from Sri Lanka, newly elected Sri Lankan government has given approval to abolish the 19th amendment which limited the presidential term. The decision on the constitution amendment comes as the first meeting of the cabinet was held in the island nation on Wednesday.
Sri Lankan government has granted approval to abolish the 19th amendment which limited the presidency in the island nation. Cabinet spokesman Kehelia Rambokwela, while addressing a media briefing, said the decision was taken at the first cabinet meeting of the new government held on Wednesday. The government has decided to retain many positive features of the 19th Amendment, such as the Right to Information Act, limiting the tenure of the president to 5 years, and keeping the two-term limit for the president when drafting a new amendment termed as the 20th Amendment to the Constitution, replacing the 19th Amendment. Present Sri Lankan President Gotabaya Rajapaksa and his brother Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapaksa had made the abolition of 19th Amendment as the main election plank during the recently held presidential and parliamentary elections. The Rajapaksa family had alleged that the amendment was brought specifically to target the family. Mahinda Rajapaksa could not contest the last November presidential elections because of the term limit and his younger brother Gotabaya became the candidate. The Rajapaksas secured two-thirds majority in parliament during general elections held this month, thus paving the way for the constitutional amendments.
Moving on to news from Nepal. Locals in Nepal's capital Kathmandu have welcomed the reimposing of coronavirus lockdown in the valley as the deadly virus cases continue to rise. In order to monitor the lockdown, police has been deployed in and around Kathmandu, checking each and every vehicle and passers-by in person.
Locals in capital Kathmandu have welcomed the coronavirus lockdown imposed in the valley till August 26, citing the new virus cases. In order to monitor the lockdown, police has also been deployed in and around Kathmandu, checking each and every vehicle and passers-by in person. Vehicles that fall under the emergency criteria set by the government and those holding passes or permits are only plying on roads.
The corona victims, they are increasing day by day, even in capital city and throughout the nation. And because to stop this all and to stop the transportation and the people's movement, the impose has the impose that I am taking as in a form of positive way, because it will ultimately prevent. Little bit prevention that has to be put by the government on the state and the society is taking.
Recent registration of coronavirus cases inside the Kathmandu Valley were reported in those who arrived in the capital lately from outside. This prompted transmission to people who never had a travel history. Meanwhile, adding to the suffering, parts of the Himalayan nation have been witnessing flood-like situation disrupting normal life. Flash flooding triggered by heavy rains have killed at least 6 people and 17 have gone missing in human settlement in Achham district of Far West Nepal. Nepal as of Thursday recorded 28,938 cases of COVID-19 with 17,700 recoveries and 120 deaths.
Bangladesh's COVID-19 tally surpassed 285,000 and the death toll reached 3,781 on Thursday. Amid the rising cases, the Health Ministry has decided to use rapid testing kits in order to increase the number of daily COVID-19 tests in the country. Bangladesh reported 2,747 new COVID-19 cases and 41 new deaths on Wednesday, making the total tally at 285,091 and total deaths at 3,781, the Directorate General of Health Services said. According to the official data, the COVID-19 fatality rate in Bangladesh is now 1.32% and the current recovery rate is 57.67% in the country. Bangladesh recorded the highest daily new cases of 4,019 on July 2 and the highest daily deaths of 64 on June 30. Bangladesh's Health Ministry has decided to use rapid testing kits in order to increase the number of daily COVID-19 tests and reduce the burden on RT-PCR-based tests. The government has also reduced COVID-19 testing fees by 50%. Meanwhile, India has assured Bangladesh that it will be a priority country when it comes to giving any Indian vaccine, said Indian Foreign Secretary Harshvardhan Shringla after meeting his Bangladesh counterpart Masood bin Momen in Dhaka on Tuesday. Bangladesh is the second country after Bhutan which has offered to be part of COVID-19 trials.
With the difficult coronavirus situation in remote parts of India, an innovation in the form of a boat ambulance in southern Kerala state has turned out to be a life saviour. Authorities have converted rescue boats into ambulances to help COVID-19 patients reach hospitals.
With rising number of COVID-19 cases in southern state of Kerala, the Kerala Water Transport Department has converted rescue boats into ambulances to help coronavirus patients reach hospitals. The ambulance has been functional in the remote areas of Alappuzha district of southern Kerala state that are isolated from the mainland, ferrying critical COVID-19 patients to hospitals. The ambulance has been active for a little over a week when COVID-19 cases in the area started to peak. They have picked up nearly 40 patients in time to be admitted to the hospitals on the mainland.
ഈ കോവിഡ് കാലത്ത് എ സി റോഡിലൂടെ വാട്ടർ ബസ് വണ്ടി പോകാത്ത ഒരു സാഹചര്യം വന്നപ്പോൾ അവിടെ നമ്മുടെ വാട്ടർ ബേസിൽ ഈ റെസ്ക്യൂ ബോട്ടുകൾ പോയി കോവിഡ് പേഷ്യൻസിനെ അത് ഈ ജീവനക്കാരാണ് അതൊക്കെ ചെയ്തത് അവർ പി പി കിറ്റൊക്കെ ധരിച്ചു അവർ പോയി പേഷ്യൻസിനെ കളക്ട് ചെയ്യും അതുപോലെ തന്നെ തിരിച്ചിവിടെ വന്നു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ഉടനെ തന്നെ നമ്മുടെ വീട് വരും നമ്മുടെ ഫയർഫോഴ്സുകാർ വന്നിട്ട് അവരത് അണുവിമുക്തമാക്കി അങ്ങനെ നമ്മൾ രാപകലില്ലാതെ രാത്രി ഒരു മണിക്ക് വരെ നമ്മൾ പേഷ്യൻസിനെ എടുത്തിട്ടുണ്ട് ശരിക്കും കുട്ടനാട്ടിൽ ഒറ്റപ്പെട്ട് പോയ കാവാലം വേണാട്ടുകാട് കുപ്പപ്പുറം അതുപോലെ തന്നെ രാമങ്കരി അങ്ങനെ വെളിയനാട് ഒരുപാട് പ്രദേശങ്ങൾ അവിടത്തെ ആ ഒരു നമ്മുടെ നദിക്ക് അല്ലെ നമ്മുടെ കുട്ടനാട്ടിലെ തോടിന് അനുയോജ്യമായ രീതിയിലുള്ള ഒരു രൂപകൽപ്പനയാണ് ഈ ബോട്ടിന് വന്നിരിക്കുന്നത്
കേരള വിച്ച് വാസ് ദ ഫസ്റ്റ് സ്റ്റേറ്റ് ടു റിപ്പോർട്ട് കോവിഡ്-19 കേസ് ഇൻ ഇന്ത്യ ഏർലിയർ ദിസ് ഇയർ ഹാസ് ഓവർ 15,000 ആക്ടീവ് കേസസ്
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/AsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter @AsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.